morning, students. Once again, I am Miss Laura greeting you a scientific day. So for today, we're gonna be having the last lesson of our bridging program and expected that next week, we're going to start our term one lessons. So since we are already ready, so let's start. Before we start our lesson, let me read to you our work plan for today. First, today's moon update. Video 1, phases of the moon and eclipses. Discussion, phases of the moon and eclipses. And we're gonna be having the 3, 2, 1 wrap up. So let us first start our lesson with today's moon update. I cannot give you the moon update, but stated here is the site wherein you can see what phase of the moon is for today. It is also linked down below this video link. And so let us now proceed to my trivia to you. The moon orbits the Earth at an average distance of 382,400 kilometers. The lunar month is the 29.53 days it takes to go from the new moon to the next. As the moon circles the Earth, the moon of the left side, we see changes. These changes are known as the phases of the moon, and it repeats in a certain way over and over. And so for today, our learning targets are: after the lesson for today, you will be able to describe the different phases of the moon, differentiate solar and lunar eclipse, and explain the importance of the moon. So let us now watch the video about moon and eclipses.
Moon phases by David Yu. So in total, there are 8 phases. The 8 phases are in this order: new moon, waxing crescent, first quarter, waxing gibbous, full moon, waning crescent, last quarter, waning gibbous, and finally back to the new moon. Waxing phases. Waxing phases are phases in which the moon gets more and more illuminated. The waxing phases are as follows: waxing crescent, first quarter, waxing gibbous, and the full moon. Waning phases. Waning phases are phases in which the moon gets less and less illuminated. The waning phases are as follows: waning crescent, last quarter, waning gibbous, and new moon. Crescent phases. Crescent phases are phases in which the moon has a little sliver of light or darkness, making it look like a crescent. The crescent phase comes in two forms: waxing and waning. Quarter phases. The quarter phases are phases in which the moon is either half lit up or half dark. Gibbous phases. The gibbous phases are phases in which the moon is either more than half illuminated or more than half in darkness. The new and full phases. The new moon is the moon fully in darkness, and the full moon is fully illuminated. As the moon orbits the Earth, it changes shape. How can you tell a moon is going broke? When it's down to its last quarter.
Okay, so that's the moon. So there was and this time, just like the Earth, half of the moon is lit by the sun, while the other half is darkness. The phase we see result from the angle the moon makes with the sun as viewed from Earth. And so, when the sunlight hits off the moon's far side, or the side we can't see without from the moon, the aid of a spacecraft, It is called a new moon. When sunlight reflects off the near side, we call it a full moon. So let us now discuss about the different phases of the moon. And the first one is the new moon. At new moon, the moon is lined up between the earth and the sun. We see the side of the moon that is not being lit by the sun. And by this, when the moon is exactly lined up with the sun, as viewed from the earth, we experience eclipse. So later on, we're going to talk about eclipse. Now let's proceed to the second phase. The second phase is what we call the crescent. After or few days after new moon, we see a thin crescent in the sky or western evening sky, and that is called crescent moon. The crescent moon waxes or appears to glow after each night. Let's proceed to the first quarter moon. The first quarter moon is when half of the moon's disk is illuminated. We call it first quarter moon. From Earth, we are now looking at the sunlit side of the moon from off to the side. Gibbous. The moon continues to wax once more than half of the disk is illuminated. It has a shape we call gibbous. The gibbous moon appears to glow flatter each night until we see the full sunlit phase of the moon, and we call it full moon. It rises almost exactly as the sun sets and sets just as the sun rises the next day. The moon has now completed one half of the lunar month. Waning gibbous. During the second half of the lunar month, the moon grows thinner each night. We call this waning. Its shape is still gibbous at this point, but grows as a little thinner each night. Last quarter. As it reaches the three-quarter point in its month, the moon once again shows us one side of its disk illuminated and the other side in darkness. That's what we call the last quarter. And so, as it completes its journey and approaches new moon again, the moon is a waning or starting in waning crescent. Now let us have a simple review of the different phases of the moon. As the sun rays directly pointing to the earth, there are different phases of the moon that we can see once we are on earth. The first is the new moon. Next is the waxing crescent. Then we have the first quarter. And then the waning gibbous. And then we're gonna be having the full moon. And let's proceed to the waning gibbous, and some part of it are in darkness, and the last quarter, after which we're gonna be having the waning crescent, and we're gonna be going back to the moon. As the moon is having its distance to the earth, there are also phenomenon wherein the moon, the earth, and the sun are aligned with each other, and that is what we call eclipse. Eclipse is when the moon or planet moves into the shadow of another heavenly body. An eclipse also takes place when Earth or the Moon passes through a shadow, and these shadows are considered to be penumbra and umbra. Umbra is the dark part of the shadow, and penumbra is the lighter or outer part of the shadow. We will also be discussing about the different lunar and solar eclipses. There are two different lunar eclipses. First is the total lunar eclipse, which occurs when the moon and the sun are on exact opposite side of Earth. And partial lunar eclipse happens when only a part of the moon enters its shadow or Earth's shadow. So as you can see, these are the two visible pictures of lunar eclipse once you see them on Earth. Now let's proceed to the different solar eclipses. Total solar eclipse is only visible for a small area on Earth. The people who see the total eclipse are in the center of the moon's shadow when it hits the Earth. Partial solar eclipse happens when the sun, the moon, and Earth are not exactly lined up. That is why we can see shadow here and a crescent light. Annular eclipse. An annular eclipse happens when the moon is farthest from Earth. Because the moon is farthest away from Earth, it seems smaller. So these are the different solar and lunar eclipses. So that ends our lesson for today. So I hope you learned something. Goodbye and God bless.